And may I please have your attention? My name is Chief Mark Stella with the Concord University Police Department. Commencement will begin shortly, and I need some help from you to ensure everyone's safety and enjoyment today. Please do not sit in the aisles. Move close to keep the aisles clear. Exits are located at the rear of the hall, on either side of the stage, and indicated by the exit signs. Please take a moment to identify these exits. If you need assistance during today's ceremonies, ushers, police officers, and emergency medical assistance are available toward the rear of the hall. If you need to go to the lobby during the ceremony, please do so quietly so those inside the hall can still hear and enjoy the ceremony. Please turn off all cell phones and other electronic devices until the conclusion of the commencement ceremony. Thank you for your help and enjoy the day.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Boil the rain.
Concord University, Dr. Kendra Bogus.
Good morning. It's good to see all of you here today. It's a chilly but beautiful morning in May, and you all have survived a year that we will never be able probably to describe. I want to thank Dr. Robinette for serving as our Grand Marshal and for her service and work as the chairperson of the Department of Business, along with the many other roles for which she is responsible. I also want to thank our dedicated faculty who normally would be sitting right behind you. We would take a minute here and we would ask them to stand and we would offer some applause to thank them for all that they did. They've certainly made a tremendous number of changes this year in order to continue to meet with you and to offer classes, and I really appreciate all they've done this year. I also want to offer some thanks to the outstanding staff members we have. You can see a few of them. Normally we have them stand, but all those folks that welcomed you out front, most of them are staff members. They work very hard to make sure that everything we do works out well. I believe there's one up here hanging from the rafters and several over there also. And if you want to give them a round of applause, I want to thank them for all they do also. Thank you all. I also want to extend my thanks to the parents, to the friends, to the alumni, the illustrious guests who are gathered to see this ceremony. And I know there are also going to be people who watch this ceremony online, or they're going to see it after we give them a jump drive later to review what happened. So special thanks go to those. And I think the greatest thanks probably go to each of you who sit here today ready to graduate. You've gone through an extraordinary year, and you've completed everything, all of the requirements, most of you. I think maybe you have an exam grade hanging yet, but most of that you've already completed. And what I hope you've learned, or you maybe want to think about, is this year has given you an opportunity to learn that you have the power to overcome adversity. I don't know if you've thought about that, but most of our lives have sailed pretty well over the last few decades, and we've never experienced something like this. So having adversity in your life is not a really terrible thing. You learn a lot about it. You learn a lot about yourself, and maybe you've learned that sometimes you can't control what happens around you, but you can control how you respond to whatever happens. And you all have done exceptional work to finish in this pandemic year. I sort of hope that all of you take a moment, and I know you've been racing around trying to get your finals done and all those papers in and say hello and goodbye and to all your friends and move things, but I hope you take a minute maybe this summer and write about this year. I mean, write it on one page or five pages, or write a book about it. This has been an extraordinary event in the lifetime of the world, and someday people are going to be looking back and wondering what it was like. So some of you have very good writing skills. Take a moment. You've overcome some incredibly difficult situations. You've made decisions that have caused you to grow in ways that I'm certain you never imagined, as have I. You've created solutions you didn't know you could create in your life. And I think you should pat yourselves on the back for it and tell yourself congratulations, because it has not been easy. But you've learned that you can do it. So what is it? What is it that you've learned? It's every intentional goal that you set for yourself, not just this year, but throughout your life. As you move forward from this day, know that you are exactly where you're supposed to be, and I hope that you find yourself in the moment and you settle yourself in every moment in your life. You have the power to decide what your life is going to be, and this is a turning point for you. You can choose to have joy in your life. You can choose to have positivity in your life, and I know most of you do. And you can ban negativity from your life, because that doesn't bring you things that are good. It doesn't bring you success. Your life story is going to be determined by the path that you choose, as it always has been. Choosing joy is your own responsibility. I hope you strive for it. I hope you insist on optimism. I hope you find yourself and you make yourself be with people who engender it and fight for those values that you care most about. But do all these things with positivity, with determination, and with kindness. You can find power within you. Recognize it. Employ it to become everything you wish to become. Define what success looks like in your life. I used to make an assignment in my classes, and it was to define success. And if I had 30 students, there were 30 definitions. If I had 50 students, there were 50 definitions, because none of us define success in the same way. Success for some people is working with children. For others, it's having a family. For others, it's making lots of money. For others, it's building a business. For others, it's helping people and being involved in communities. It's so many things. What is it in your life? Make sure you know and that you push yourself to do those things that matter to you. And I suggest that you work to make your life spectacular, because each and every one of you can. You have that power within you, and you have the educational foundation to change what you're doing and where you're going. You can move in new and exciting directions and learn what the outcome might be if you try what is extremely frightening to many people, and that is change. You all have already demonstrated that you're pretty good at change. This year has made us all be better at change, and we can't change that. Change will not stop. Every single particle in the universe, for those of you who had one biology class, you know that every single particle in the universe is changing every minute. And that when we think we don't need to change, we need to probably re-examine the way we're thinking. So when change comes, the power that you have is to know what you will do and how you will adapt to it. So all this, the faculty here, all the staff here at Concord, hope you remember the experiences you have here positively, even those that are difficult, the courses that you survived, the exams that you dreaded, you hated, you thought you weren't going to make it through, but you did, the activities in which you participated, all the friendships you made, the faculty members who care about you, staff members who supported you, and I hope myself that you remember Concord in a most positive light, and that you know we're here to continue to support you and help you. Today's just the first step in your journey. I also hope that you set big, big, big dreams and goals for yourself. Make them gigantic. Make them preposterous. Make them fun. And then make your life be about reaching those goals. Never stop learning new things. You never know where life will take you. Every single person, and I would imagine you could ask your parents and loved ones here about what their goals were when they got out of high school, or they got out of a college, or they just began their adult lives, and they would probably tell you, I never expected to be here. This was not what I thought my life would be about. And I would suspect that many of you will say this same thing one day. So make sure you never stop learning, that you set goals that are very, very difficult or challenging to make, so that you know one day when you look back, I've done something really good, I've left something really good here in the world. It matters, and it will matter to you, I believe. I have to say, as I do at every commencement, there are two things that I believe are the most linked to success. Those are hard work and determination. Hard work matters. If anybody's told you it doesn't, they are lying to you. Hard work matters. And determination and not giving up matters. So make sure those are part of your tool of things that you get through life with. Take with you the gifts of service, of kindness, patience, willingness to help others, and the encouragement that each of you have received from these folks sitting around around you, from others here at Concord, and show that to others throughout your lifetime. I know that many of you have already paid it forward. Continue to pay it forward. We can build a world that is very, very good for everyone and very kind. Take with you the heart of the campus beautiful. Share it with others. Concord will be with you, and we are continuing to care about what happens to you after you walk outside these doors. So come back and visit when you can. We know that you will make every place you go better. You'll carry the knowledge that you've earned with you. We hope you continue to strive to make this area, this region, this state, this country, and the world a better place. We'll be here to partner with you and cheer you on. We are just so honored to be here to offer you congratulations and to celebrate for a moment of your day. We're so proud of you, Mountain Lions, and we send you forward with the best of wishes to make every one of your dreams and goals come true. Thank you.
We would now like to recognize our students graduating with institutional and field honors. Will those students please stand to be recognized? At this time, the candidates for degrees in course will be presented to the president by Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Edward Hufstetler. The class of 2021 will please stand.
President Bogus, pending the submission of semester grades, the ladies and gentlemen standing before you have fulfilled all the requirements for the bachelor's degree as prescribed by the Concord University Board of Governors and the faculty of Concord University. I am pleased to present these candidates to you for recognition and the granting of degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors and the laws of West Virginia, and on behalf of the faculty of Concord University, I hereby confer upon each of you the appropriate degree you have earned in accordance with the testimonials you are about to receive, and I declare you worthy of all the rights, privileges, immunities, honors, and signal obligations here and elsewhere belonging to this degree.
The class of 2021 will please be seated. The audience will please refrain from applause until all graduates have received diplomas. The graduates will now come forward to receive their diplomas in order indicated in the commencement program.
Although official diplomas will be available or mailed to graduates in the near future, all participants will receive appropriate documents today.
Dr. Edward Hufstetler will announce each of the graduates.
At this time, undergraduate candidates from the College of Professional and Liberal Studies, which includes the Department of Business and the Department of Mass Communications, and the candidates from the College of Science, Mathematics, and Health, which includes the Department of Mathematics and Computer Science, will receive their diplomas. Louis David B. Malumba, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in Management. Joseph A. Bisaha, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in Management. Gabrielle Renee Klein, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration. Chance Austin Davis, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Jessica Dawn DeVore, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Olivia Grace Dougherty, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. Savannah Lee Dunford, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in sports management. Liam Andrew Evans, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in finance. Riley P. Fitzwater, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Bryant Alexander Grubb, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Elizabeth Caitlin Hall, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Jamie K. Hogan, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in marketing. William B. Honecker, Bachelor of Science in Recreation and Tourism Management with a concentration in Park and Recreation Management. Spencer Clay Hoyt, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Skylar Renee Jenkins, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in sports management. Melek Berjan Johnson, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in finance. Tyler Sidney Jones, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. Martin Kelly Jr., Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in finance. Hyojin Kim, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Caleb Samuel Lester, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in sports management. Joanthony Hernandez, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in sports management. Taylor Marie Long, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in marketing and a concentration in management. Matthew Ty Mouse, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Matthew Calvin Mullins, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, concentration in management. John Marshall Osteen, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Shiloh Rain Parrish, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. Trent Nolan Pennington, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with concentrations in management and marketing. Stephen Wayne Price, summa cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. Jacob Aaron Rutherford, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in finance. Michael Joseph Schrader, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. Anthony Jacob Stalen, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in accounting. John Thomas Turner, summa cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Nina Marie Yap, Bachelor of Science in Business Administration with a concentration in management. Carissa Diane Bowden, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Brandon Christopher Eanes, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Hannah Nicole Gates, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Riley Parker Griffith, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Austin James Harmon, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Tiffany Renee Mosley, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Shannon Cameron White, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication, magna cum laude. James E. Wilburn, Bachelor of Science in Mass Communication. Bevan J. Ekman, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. Fevan Tefahanes Gebrehiwat, Bachelor of Science in Computer Information Systems. Dui Quang Li, cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. Diego Marti Perez, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. Giovanni R. Cumbayo, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science. Kaylin Nicole Sheely, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science, Computer Information Systems.
Please stand and join us in singing the Concord University alma mater located on the back cover of your commencement program.
Concord, we hail thee, hats off to you.
Standing custom, it is time for graduates to move their tassel from the right to the left. Congratulations, graduates.
Graduates, please remain standing. The audience may be seated for the recessional.
Thank you. bloodshot eyes and my cold sober view. Didn't like that I came home late, 4 a.m., but it's a Friday, babe, and I've been working hard. Can't you give me some space that I'm shouting out? Oh my God.